Modeling simulation is one of the classes that every student takes in their first semester at Olin, using the models to do something useful.
They start off by showing us this map. Basically, they say, this is your environment, this is your real world. We're going to take one part of this world and abstract it, simplify it down to the necessary components, and then we're going to make a mathematical model of this. After we make the mathematical model in MATLAB, we analyze the data and we tie it back to the real world to see how it actually fits in. So that's how the class starts.
Modeling and simulation, like a number of classes at Olin, is taught in a studio setting, which is sort of inspired by the way that people often work in a design studio or an architecture studio. The idea is that students have a space that they're working in. They're working either in teams or working individually, but they're working on something at their own pace with the instructor acting much more as a coach and as someone who's giving critiques and helping them think about things than someone who's standing in front and telling them what the answer is. What our hope is that coming out of this class, they will instead be able to look at real physical situations and say, okay, I can identify two or three ways that I could model that, because that idea of actually using the sort of ideas in mathematics and science in order to do something that where you're actually making an argument to someone isn't something that's emphasized in high school. Honestly, it's not something that's emphasized very often in college, but at the end of the day, that's what it's for.
It's not just math, it's not just science, and it's not just programming. It's a process, it's modeling, and the whole process is to do work. I remember halfway through the semester, there was a survey sent out, how is ModSim going? And the class changed after that, the feeling of it changed. And for professors to really have that type of open feedback, it really helps. It really helps. There's no other way that innovation could occur if they didn't have that type of communication.
My favorite thing about teaching at Olin is when class ends and you have to tell everyone that class ended. For students to be engaged in that way where they actually forget time and they're sort of in the flow and they're excited about what they're doing and working on it hard enough that they forget to watch their watches. That's pretty cool. I like that.